Hi, I'm Alex Castle, and this is Maximum PC. Today I'm looking at the SteelSeries Shift. It's their newest... one of their two new keyboards. This one is definitely the more feature-heavy of the two, that's why I'm showing it off on video here. It's not a full review for that. That'll be on the site pretty soon, but for now, I'm just going to walk you through what's up with the Shift. First, as you can see, it's a pretty solid-looking keyboard. It's got this big wrist rest, but you can get rid of that easily. Pops right off. Second, it's got a whole row of macro keys up the top. You can see them right here, numbered 1 through 8. And then there are also three macro sort of set buttons. So, you know, when you have one activated, they do one thing. When you have two activated, they do another thing. Basically, it's like you get 24 macros. The macros are hot or on-the-fly recordable. I think that's what they call it. So you just press the record button, you type your macro in, you press the one you want to bind it to, and it saves it right in there. And then you can actually go in with software later on and manually edit the macros if you want to change the timing or something like that. In addition to the button macros, you can actually rebind any of the keys in combination with these bar and pad keys. Those are just sort of made up words, kind of like, I mean, they are like another shift key or another alt key, so you can bind bar plus T to something, or you can bind pad plus T to something, or you can even bind bar and pad plus T. So basically you get about a billion key binds. Makes it a good keyboard for MMO gamers, people who use a lot of different customizable keys. The most interesting thing about the Shift, though, is not in that or the media keys around the side. What's really unusual about the Shift is that the keys come off. You might remember the Z-board from a while back. It was basically a keyboard with interchangeable key sets. Well, the Shift is the new Z-board, because SteelSeries bought Z-board a while back. And while the Z-board was a little bit flimsy, you know, not the greatest keyboard in the world, they've clearly set out to make it a much more sturdy, gamer-friendly keyboard with the Shift. They sent me a couple of sample key sets. I got World of Warcraft and a StarCraft one right here. I think the Warcraft one's a little bit old because it still says Z-board on it. StarCraft one looks pretty current, so I'll put that on right now. Just sort of slip it in like that. And just like that, you've got a whole new set of keys. Not all of these use the keys that well. I mean, if you look at them, the StarCraft one has about 8 special keys that aren't on a normal keyboard, but nonetheless, pretty cool. The downside to that is that with all the switching going on, you can't use mechanical keys. It uses the rubber dome keys. Makes them a little less fun to type on, a little less responsive, and also, if you zoom in, you can see here, they have to split the space bar into two different keys, which, not a big deal, but takes a while to get used to. I mean, you're probably used to having one big space bar. Otherwise, very cool keyboard. Keep your eyes peeled for a full review here on MaximumPC.com and in the magazine. I'm Alex Castle.